Charles Ivy Virtual Christmas Pageant. We are delighted to share the spirit of Christmas with you.
Holy season, we celebrate good news and great joy. God has sent his Son to live among us and fulfill his purpose. Hear the words of the prophet Isaiah, foretelling the birth of the Messiah and the coming of his kingdom.
Arise, shine, for the light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darknesses of the peoples. But the Lord will rise upon you, and this his glory will be seen upon you. And nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising.
Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert of the high for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill made low. The crooked place is straight, and the rough place is plain. For behold, a virgin shall conceive, and a bear son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
The people that live in the darkness have seen a great light. On those who live in a land of shadow, a light has shone for a child that has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders. And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
And it came to pass that the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary.
Hail Mary, O favored one, do not be afraid, for the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. Behold, you shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
How will this be?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, for nothing is impossible with God.
I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word.
At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, my kinswoman.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? Blessed is she who has believed that what the Lord said to her will be accomplished.
He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants, even as he said to our fathers.
Thou shalt come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse. A branch shall grow out of its roots. A spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him.
The spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of our Lord. With righteousness shall he judge the poor.
The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion in the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them.
The prophets tell us about a wonderful Savior.
Yes, a baby who will grow up to lead us in God's way. Hallelujah.
And he will be with us forever.
And it came to pass in those days that the decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be enrolled, each in his own city.
Caesar Augustus hath issued a decree. Everyone must return to his birthplace to be taxed. Make haste, make haste.
And Joseph also went up from Galilee to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was great with child.
Look, Mary, I see the lights of David's city.
Thanks be to God, I can scarcely go another step.
Take heart, Mary.
But when they arrived, the city was already very crowded with other people who had come to be registered, and all of the inns were full. Joseph sought shelter at several inns anyway, in the hope that someone might spare a room.
We have traveled a long way and are very tired. Is there any room at your inn?
Who goes there so late at night?
Weary travelers seeking lodging?
Do you have a room where my wife and I can stay the night?
No lodging here tonight. All is full.
Please, my wife is with child. Is there nowhere we can rest a while?
Mercy upon us. Is there nothing we can do for this poor woman? I know. Come, we'll put you in the stable. It isn't much, but it's warm and dry.
Thank you. You're very kind. We'll be comfortable there.
While they were there, the time came for Mary to bear her child. and she gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger.
Same country, shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
Oh, it is a cold night.
Whose turn is it to watch?
It's my turn. Now all of you can rest a while.
Appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior.
He is Christ the Lord, and this will be a sign for you. You'll find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was, with the angels, a great throng of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest and peace to his people on earth.
The Messiah is born. Did you hear them?
They said he's in a stable in Bethlehem.
Praise the Lord. Let all of us go see him.
And the shepherds went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they glorified and praised God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them.
Thank you.
Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king. There came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, and they sought and received audience with the king.
Where is he that has been born king of the Jews?
For we have seen his star in the east,
and we have come to worship him.
Go to Bethlehem and search for the child, and when you have found him, let me know so that I too may come and worship him.
And the star which shone in the east went before them, until it came and stood over where the young child was.
And going into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and they fell down to worship him, and they presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Hail, King of Kings, I offer you this gift of gold.
Hail, King of Heaven, I offer you this gift of frankincense.
Hail, King of Sorrows, I offer you this gift of myrrh.
In being warned by God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And Mary, his mother, kept all these things, pondering them in her heart.
And so the prophecies of old were at last fulfilled, as they have been fulfilled for all of us who come to the manger to celebrate the birthday of our Lord and Savior.
Hallelujah, peace and joy to the world.
Thank you.